Bhavani. I'm a graphic designer and illustrator from Bombay. I did my bachelor's in applied art, and then I went on to do my master's in graphic design. And since the last few years, I have worked with different design studios and dabbled in different areas of design. So I have done packaging design, I have done signage, I have done illustration, and more recently I have been into book design. I'm so happy that you guys are starting your journeys in design, like you're trying to explore a career in the creative industry, and you're starting this journey with Dot School of Design. So when I decided to go into design school, the only thing I knew was that I enjoyed drawing more than other things, and thankfully my parents and my friends also agreed that I was good at it. So that gave me some confidence to enroll for art school. But it was only much later when you actually start being part of the art and design industry that you learn that the world is so much more wide and expansive. So what do you mean by that? Drawing and painting are some skills that you will not only learn and get better at, but these are not the only skills that are involved in design. So to have a successful design project, you might require reasoning skills or analytical skills, observation skills, your leadership skills, whether you are somebody who can, like, you know, work with other people in a team, or you are somebody who can put in long hours and work alone, because some projects require that kind of a focus. Whether you are a good leader, like, do you have good leadership skills or time management or project management skills? So there are lots of different things, and also a lot of different things you learn at school which you feel might never be applicable. Like, I personally hated maths in school, and when I joined design, I thought ki ye, like, I completely can, like, not look back at maths and only continue to draw and draw. But every time I'm designing a book, there are grids and there are things where I require basic math skills, and so many different things come into play, like humanities, your understanding of the world, how you look at things. All these things really make your engagement with a design project very rich. So like, you might already have some skills, and some skills you intuitively know you can, like, get better at, and some of the things which you are not familiar with, you will pick it up in school or on the job along the way. But I feel each of us have some unique set of skills which we are not always aware of, and they will all come very handy when you start working in design. And in your early years of design college, you will also get introduced to many different areas, and you will dabble in a lot of different things, and you will discover that maybe you are somebody who wants to direct all your creative energies towards one thing. Like, you are somebody who wants to specialize in maybe, say, type design or children's book illustrations, or only photography, or just furniture design. Even within furniture design, you might say that, okay, I am somebody who only does who does explorations in furniture in bamboo. So it can be very, very specific, but you can also be somebody who thrives better in a multidisciplinary or in a cross-disciplinary environment. So you might have enrolled for a graphic design course, and you might feel that, oh, I'm also very excited by ceramics, or I would like to explore web design, or I would like to explore, I don't know, filmmaking. So design is a field that will let you do these things together, and you will start learning different things from each of these areas, and slowly over a period of time, your learnings from these different things will start feeding into each other, and then what you do as a creative person might be very unique. There might not be a post like this, or there might not be a role like this which existed before, but you are that person who is now combined these things together, and you have found a unique place of how you contribute to design and how you engage with design. So the journey for design for each of you might be very, very different, and each one of it will be unique and very exciting. And through these years where you study and work, you will also have multiple conversations about what is design. There are so many theories and so many definitions, and you might relate to some of them more than a few others, and you might even come up with your own theories. Like, I still am not sure which design definition or what role of a designer suits me, and that conversation is ever evolving and changing. But the best part about design is that it is not restricting at all. So it is one profession that lets you also dabble in other professions. So what do you mean by that? So you might have chosen ki, this is the career choice or this is the profession I want to be in. So you decide you want the label of a visual communicator or a graphic designer or something like that. But you are also somebody who's very interested in music or astronomy or medical sciences or biology or social sciences, social justice. There could be a wide variety of subjects that you are keen on knowing more. But the thing is, you don't have to switch careers try to have multiple careers. Design is one profession that lets you engage with all these other things simultaneously. Because all of these other professions also require design to survive. So I can be somebody who is very interested in humanities. So the kind of design projects I take up will be very focusing on social development or social justice. Somebody else might be very interested in music. So that person might consciously choose projects which are designing apps for music or simplifying music teaching. So the possibilities are really endless, because design is a way you can talk to so many other fields, and you can also change it over the years. You might be obsessed with astronomy all your life, and after one day you wake up when you are 45 and you are now I want to do gardening. But as a designer, you can take up more gardening related subjects to design, and you can also dabble in gardening in your personal life. So I just think that it is a very wide world, but it also allows you to have very niche interests, and the possibilities are great. So I hope you are excited to begin your journeys here, and I wish you all the very best to discover your own. And welcome to the world of design. Goodbye.